important for us. Okay. Now, we have a drug known as primidone. Primidone is a prodrug. It is a prodrug. Prodrug means it is an inactive drug, and inside the body it gets converted into active form, that is phenobarbital. Okay. So primidone is a similar drug to phenobarbital. Now let's talk about the uses of phenobarbital. Now phenobarbital, remember, it is a drug of choice for neonatal seizures because it is safe drug in neonates like GTCS, etc. Okay, it is also the drug of choice for neonatal jaundice. Okay, neonatal jaundice. Now, which neonatal jaundice? We will write Crigler-Najjar syndrome. Which syndrome? Type 2. It can also be given in Gilbert syndrome. Okay. Now, what happens in neonatal jaundice? In neonatal jaundice, the level of bilirubin in the neonate increases. Why? Because this bilirubin is not conjugated by a molecule known as glucuronide. This glucuronide molecule, when attaches with bilirubin, bilirubin becomes water soluble. Okay. And this bilirubin now can be removed out of the body in urine. But what happens in this neonatal jaundice? This glucuronide cannot be attached. Why? Because there is some defect in an enzyme, UDP-GT. UDP-GT is uridine diphosphate glucuronide transferase. Just write the short form. Now, why phenobarbital is given? Because phenobarbital is an enzyme inducer. It increases the activity of UDP-GT. Because of this reason, bilirubin can now easily be conjugated or linked with glucuronide, and it can be removed out of the body easily. Because of the property of enzyme induction or inducer, it is used in neonatal jaundice. Okay. Now let's talk about pharmacokinetics. We know it is an enzyme inducer. The second point we will write, how it is eliminated out, how phenobarbital is removed out of the body. Phenobarbital, 3/4 or 75% is metabolized in liver, and after metabolism it is excreted out in urine. While 1/4 of phenobarbital or 25%, it is not metabolized in liver and it is excreted unchanged in urine. It is excreted unchanged in urine. Okay. Now, what are the side effects? We know that phenobarbital is a sedative drug, so it produces sedation. Okay. It all barbiturate, they cause memory loss if they are used in long term basis. Okay. Now, sometimes when it is given in neonates or children, sometimes this phenobarbital may paradoxically means oppositely, it rather causes seizure. It itself may cause seizure. Why it causes, it is unknown, but it paradoxically causes seizures. Okay, it itself may produce seizure, and it may also produce excitation or hyperkinesia in children. So instead of producing sedation, it produces hyperkinesia, excessive movement. But it occurs in very small number of people. Okay, very small number of people. Okay, now here only we will write side effect of overall all barbiturate. Side effect of all barbiturates. Okay, the first point is barbiturate, we know they are sedative drug. Because of this reason, and they are hypnotic. Can we say that these drugs can be used for the treatment of insomnia? When a person is not able to sleep, it is known as insomnia. And hypnotic drug, they induce sleep. So can they be used in treatment of insomnia? The answer is yes. But the point is, nowadays, we don't use barbiturate for the treatment of insomnia. Barbiturate, they are not used in treatment of insomnia. Okay, in insomnia treatment we rather use benzodiazepines. And two drugs which are only made for insomnia, no other use, that is atypical benzodiazepine, they are only made for the treatment of insomnia, and melatonin like drugs, melatonins like drug. These drugs are only used for the treatment of insomnia, while benzodiazepines will have many other use. So barbiturate, now they are not used for the treatment of insomnia. The answer is why? Because they will induce sleep, but the problem is they distort sleep cycle. They distort sleep cycle of an individual. Okay, there is a sleep pattern which will be distorted. Now how a person sleeps, remember, when a person sleeps, the first phase of sleep is known as NREM, non-rapid eye movement. This is the first phase. Then the person goes into second phase, then the person goes into third phase and fourth phase. After that the patient goes into REM, then again patient has NREM, then the again patient has REM. This is how the sleep cycle progresses. Now the point is, if we talk about these initial stages 1 and 2, they are very uncomfortable sleep, okay, and these 4 and 5, they are very comfortable sleep. Now what happens with barbiturate? When we give barbiturate, they increase the duration of NREM 2 and the person will have uncomfortable sleep. That if you will just say the name of a patient, the patient will wake up, okay, uncomfortable sleep, okay, and they will decrease the duration of deep sleep. That deep sleep is NREM 4 and REM. Okay, so they decrease the duration of deep or comfortable sleep. Because of this reason, when a person will take barbiturate, the person will have frequent awakenings. The patient will have frequent awakenings in the night, okay, and the patient will have next day hangover, and the person may have rebound insomnia. If the patient will stop taking this drug, the patient will have rebound insomnia. The person will not able to take a drug. Because of these properties, nowadays we don't give barbiturate for the treatment of insomnia. Okay. Now the last point with barbiturate we will write is, barbiturates, they are absolutely contraindicated in porphyrias. Okay. They are absolutely contraindicated in porphyria, like example, acute intermittent porphyria. Okay. Now what is porphyria? In porphyria, what happens? In porphyria, there is some enzyme deficiency. Which enzyme deficiency? The enzymes which are responsible for synthesis of heme. Okay. Synthesis of heme. So remember, we don't give barbiturates in cases of porphyria, but it is safe to give benzodiazepines, and especially short acting benzodiazepines like midazolam. So benzodiazepines are safe to be given, and opioids are also safe to be given in porphyria, while barbiturates, they are contraindicated in porphyria. Now what are the drugs overall? What is the list of the drugs which are contraindicated in porphyria? So the drugs which are contraindicated in porphyria, the list is, remember, general pharma, all enzyme inducer and all enzyme inhibitors are contraindicated in porphyria. Okay. All enzyme inducers and inhibitors are contraindicated in porphyria, but we will write a mnemonic. Okay, so we will write a mnemonic of porphyria. We can write severe पोर्फाइरिया। ओके, सो वी विल राइट एस फॉर सल्फोनामाइड्स, दे आर कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन पोर्फाइरिया, इरगोट्स, वेलप्रोइट, एरिथ्रोमाइसिन। ओके, एरिथ्रोमाइसिन, देन यू विल राइट ईस्ट्रोजन्स और ओसीपी। पी फॉर यू विल राइट फिनोबार्बिटॉन और यू विल राइट होल बार्बिट्यूरेट्स। ऑल बार्बिट्यूरेट्स आर जनरली कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड। ओके, ओ फॉर यू विल राइट ऑक्स कार्बाजपीन विच इज एन एंटी एपिलेप्टिक, द ब्रदर इज कार्बामेजपीन। यू विल राइट प्रोजेस्टेरॉन, फेनिटोइन एंड रिफैम्पिसिन। ओके, फ्रॉम ए यू विल राइट टू ड्रग्स, द फर्स्ट इज एल्कोहल, एल्कोहल इज कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेटेड इन पोर्फाइरिया, एंड सेकेंड यू विल राइट एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट्स। नाउ विच एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट, यू विल राइट थ्री एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट, थायोपेंटोन, कीटामीन एंड हेलोथेन। दीज थ्री एनेस्थेटिक एजेंट शुड बी अवॉइडेड इन पोर्फाइरिया। ओके, सो रिमेंबर दिस पार्ट। Now, this is all about barbiturate, you must need to remember, and we will be discussing this phenobarbital in great detail in a lecture known as epilepsy. Okay, in epilepsy we will discuss this drug in great detail. Now let's make a heading, benzodiazepines.